Hey everybody, it's Brittany with Divine Bloom. If you're new here, welcome, 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 virtual hug. I'm so glad you're here. If you're coming back, I'm so glad that you guys came back to hang out with me. Listen, if this video helps you or blesses you in any way, please, please, please hit that like and subscribe button. This way you'll be the first to be notified when new videos are released. Y'all, today, this video is probably one of the most important topics that I've ever covered. Today, we're talking about winning the war on worry. And I recently did a video on overcoming the battle of perfectionism. If you haven't checked it out, click right there and check it out. But in the video, I mentioned the top five regrets that people had at the end of their lives. And the number one regret, catch this, is that people spent too much time worrying. That was their number one regret. They spent too much time worrying. And I don't know about you, but I don't want to get to the end of my life and realize that I've wasted years and decades on worry. Worried about things that I can't change. Worried about things that I don't have any control over. Worried about people that aren't worried about me. Hello, somebody. I don't want to live my life like that. And I know that you probably don't either. So whoever's on the other side of the camera, let me look at you. Yes, you. I want to tell you, stop worrying, okay? This excessive worrying that you're doing, it's detrimental to your physical health, your mental health, and your spiritual health. Now, I know that some of you are thinking like, Brittany, girl, how can you tell me not to worry? You don't know my situation. You don't know what I'm facing. You don't know how hard it is right now. I mean, we're in the middle of a pandemic. How can you tell me not to worry? Well, I can tell you not to worry because I serve a big and a mighty and a capable God. And if you have a relationship with him, there's some promises that he made. He promised that he would never leave us or forsake us. He promised that he would be with us wherever we go, Joshua 1:9. He promised that he would supply all of our needs according to his glorious riches in Christ Jesus, Philippians 4:19. See, the very thing that you're worried about the most, God is already taking care of. So on today, guys, I want you to win this war on worry, and I'm going to show you three things that you could do to do this. All right, so stay tuned. Today we're talking about winning the war on worry. Now listen, I know there's a difference between concern and worry. We're human, so we all have concerns, but concern is when we are in control of our thoughts and feelings about a particular issue or circumstance. But worry is when we have no control. I mean, this is the type of worry, it keeps you up at night, you're pacing the floor, there's knots in your stomach, it paralyzes you. And worry, it's like a merry-go-round, it just goes round and round, and you just end up where you started with nothing changed, nothing fixed. It's pointless. So let me show you what you need to do to win this war on worry. Number one, you have to stop torturing your mind with the what ifs. Get out of the what if rabbit hole. What if I die alone? What if my kids grow up and turn out to be bad people? What if I never get married? What if I never have children? What if my spouse leaves me? What if I never reach my goal? What if people don't like me? Listen, you will literally make yourself sick if you stay on this what if rabbit hole. Start telling yourself, you know what? I'm going to cross that bridge when I get to it. And when you find yourself in that what if rabbit hole, I need you to start retraining your brain. And we retrain our brain by meditating on the word of God. Scripture tells us in Philippians 4:8, to think on things that are true, that are just, that are admirable, praiseworthy, and of a good report. Start flipping the script on your what if. Instead of asking yourself in the negative, train your brain for the positive. What if I do succeed? What if my children grow up and become great people? What if I find a spouse? How can I get ready for that? What if my business, what if it does succeed? What if I do prosper? So flip the script on your what if. All right, number two, this is a hard one to swallow, but you have to check your faith. See, when we worry, we are telling God, I don't think you're big enough. I don't think you could solve this problem. I don't think you're mighty enough. I think that it's too big for you, this grief, this pain. I don't think you can handle it. And I don't know about you, but I don't want to insult God like that because he is bigger. He's bigger than my problems. He's bigger than my circumstances. He's bigger than any failure. He's bigger than anything. So when you worry, you're telling God you're not big enough, but he is big enough. And so I have to ask you, where is your faith? All right, number three, if you want to win the battle on worry, turn your worry list into a prayer list. I know it sounds super churchy and cliche-ish, but it's just the God honest truth. 1 Peter 5:7, it says, cast your care, cast your worry, cast your concern on the Lord because he cares for you. This is exactly what I do. Every time I'm worried, I write that thing down and I cross-reference it with the word of God. When I feel alone, have you ever felt alone? I say, I'm alone, God, but your word says that you would never leave me nor forsake me. When I feel like something's impossible, anybody ever felt like something was impossible? In your word, it says that all things are possible. So let me check that off my list. That's what you do. You turn your worry list into a prayer list. See, this is exactly what I do. I take all of my worries, I write them down, And when I get ready to pray, I'll go back over this list and take it to God. That's it. So friends, I want you to win this battle against worry. You are not watching this video by accident. Remember, whatever you're worried about the most, God is already taken care of. It's handled. So if you're looking for more resources that'll help you on your spiritual growth journey, please do me this favor. Head over to my website at www.mydivinebloom.com and check out the blogs as well as the free resources. You're going to win this war on worry, all right? You know the drill. You know what to do. I need you to stay rooted in God. We will talk again soon. Peace.